system on behalf of Islamic countries and the paradigm of the justice system to be established. I will be sharing my screen.
Hakan Tanrıverdi Paşa'mıza ve kongrelerin hayata geçirilmesinde katkısı olan Assam'ın üye ve yöneticilerine teşekkür
ederim. Ladies and gentlemen, I would like to thank everyone who have contributed to this organization and I would like to thank the participants for joining us today.
Şu an gözüküyor mu?
Can you see my screen?
Buyurun hocam.
Yes.
Sunacağım bildiri İslam ülkeleri adına adalet sisteminin önemi ve oluşturucu.
I will be talking about the importance of the justice system on behalf of Islamic countries and the paradigm of the justice system to be established. To make an introduction, justice is the backbone of societies and it's the key to sustainable development. Creating a joint justice system in Islamic countries is not just about improving the existing legal infrastructure, but it can also link together cultural and religious values. And creating a shared justice system creates many opportunities, such as enriching cultural diversity, in boosting community trust in the community, and more effectively implementing law in the Islamic principles in the law. So taking action in this direction will help Islamic countries to strengthen their domestic systems and be more effectively represented in the international level. So we would also like to talk about the genocide in Palestine that has been going on since October 7th. And in the past, Mehmet II adopted a policy towards Western countries, and we see a similar situation today. But one difference, in the past, it was Mehmet who was the intelligent one, but this time, we are not the intelligent ones. For example, after the conquest of Istanbul, Mehmet the Conqueror supported the Orthodox Church. Why? Because he wanted to keep the divisions between the sects in the Christian world and control the Orthodox Church. And today, the Islamic world is going through a similar thing, and they cannot show a defense. For example, there are still some divisions between Islamic countries. And the evolution of and history of the justice system in the Islamic countries should be understood. It is important. This is important to understand the current situation. The justice system in the Islamic countries has a well-established historical depth, and this evolution process has been shaped by the Weil Halik's book, Introduction to Islamic Law, and the basic principles and past practices of Islamic law has shaped the evolution of this system. Marshall G.S. Hudgens' work, The Initiative of Islam, lays the foundations of the understanding, foundations of the justice in the Islamic world with the Prophet Muhammad. It dates back to the time of Muhammad. According to Hudson, in this period, justice was adopted as a fundamental principle of the society, and this understanding continued its existence since the establishment of Islamic states. According to Christopher Weiramantri's book, Islamic Law, An International Perspective, it is seen that the social political changes affect the justice system and lead to various evolutions throughout history and cultural and religious dimensions. The cultural and religious dimensions of justice shaped on Islamic basis mean that Law in the Islamic world goes beyond being just a normative framework. In this context, the Quran and the Hadith, which are the basic sources of Islam, explain in detail the principles of ensuring justice, how to integrate Islamic culture and religious values while creating a justice system is important in creating a fair paradigm. To look at the creation and the missions of the European Court of Human Rights, the European Court of Human Rights, ECHR, is based on the European Convention on Human Rights, which was signed in 1950 and entered into force in 1953. The Court of Human Rights was established among the member states of the Council of Europe to protect the fundamental rights and freedoms of individuals. And this is the creation of the European Council Convention. And the European Court of Human Rights. In 1949, after the World War II, 12 member states of the new Council of Europe began working on the European Convention of Human Rights, which included the provisions already mentioned in the declaration, such as the right to life, the prohibition of torture, the right to liberty and security. While it was inspired by the rights to a fair trial and freedom of expression, it was determined that there would be a judicial mechanism for the European countries that they would ensure the fundamental rights of the citizens would be respected. And the establishment of the European Court of Human Rights, it took place within the framework of the European Convention of Human Rights. Following the entry into force of the convention, the ECHR began its operations in Strasbourg. On this day, detailed rules were determined regarding the powers and functioning of the court, and the court was established to protect the rights of individuals against states and to address cases of violations. And introduction of the right of individual application. This happened 32 years after the court was created. The court was initially tasked with handling interstate cases. However, in 1981, ECHR recognized the right of individuals to apply directly. This allowed individuals to persecute states for human rights violations by appealing directly to this court. Trial and decision processes. The court handles applications brought by individuals against their states. The litigation process includes the stages of parties expressing their opinions, presenting evidence, and the court making a decision. Decisions are binding and must be implemented by the states. Protocols and expansion. Various protocols and agreements were adopted to expand the powers of the European Court of Human Rights and provide access to more individuals. In addition to the convention, various protocols and additional documents have been adopted to further improve the functioning of the ECHR. ECHR is the court to which citizens of the 47 member states of the Council of Europe can apply. Its main mission can be set to protect and implement the rights and freedoms stipulated in the European Convention on Human Rights. Of course, at this point, instead of creating a legal reform in nation states on behalf of Islamic countries, an international mechanism should be created by member states, and this must be a priority. At this point, basic Islamic laws, legal infrastructures, and reform perspective for common justice system. It is necessary to focus on the existing legal infrastructure in Islamic countries and how reforms in this field can form the basis of a common justice system. In this regard, the current legal infrastructure in Islamic countries is generally a reflection of today's legal norms and practices, but deficiencies in this field and changing social needs necessitate reforms and open the doors of an evolution that will form the basis of a common justice system. Reshaping the justice system has a close connection with the deep-rooted foundations of the Islamic law, existing legal infrastructures, and the reforms that need to be made. In this context, it is important to implement efforts to establish a new justice system by examining the teachings of Islamic law, existing legal infrastructures, and when necessary, taking radical reforms. The works of leading scholars of Islamic law can help us understand the basic principles and evolution of Islamic law that form the basis of this effort. Cooperation and diplomacy for the new phase of justice, strategic approach. Cooperation and diplomatic efforts on the justice system among Islamic countries provide important strategic elements for the development of a common paradigm and starting a new era in the evolution of justice. An effort is needed to explore how justice can be achieved from a global perspective in line with the basic principles of Islamic law. To understand the evolution of the justice system in the Islamic world, Lawrence Rosen's Islamic Justice, Comparative Perspectives on Islamic Law and Society offers some understanding. We can examine how justice is perceived among different cultures and communities and how these perceptions overlap with each other. Through the work of Christopher Weeramantri, Islamic Law, an International Perspective, and the works of other experts, we can examine strategic approaches to exploring how a justice system can be created through cooperation and diplomacy on a global level. Diplomacy can be the cornerstone of a new justice system. This means that stakeholders in the Islamic world and international arena should come together for a common goal. Education and knowledge, the role of education in building the future of common justice. Ensuring a common unit of justice is closely related not only to the reform of existing systems, but also to the development of individuals and society's understanding of justice. In this context, education and information plays an important role among the cornerstones of a new justice system. Education, understanding the main education offers a powerful platform to understand the basic principles of justice, evaluate social justice, and learn how individuals can contribute to these concepts. John Rawls' work can be a useful starting point. The role of technology in education cannot be ignored, like e-learning and digital resources can provide powerful tools to promote concepts of justice to broad audiences. Martha Nussbaum's work offers an in-depth examination of how education can play an important role in social justice. It emphasizes, when we look at the applicability of the common justice paradigm, and the challenges it may face, a detailed examination of innovative and fair approach in the real world. We see integrating the balancing the powers between the stakeholders will be an important component and explaining this paradigm to the society are very important. The success of an innovative justice system paradigm depends on society accepting and embracing this change. At this point, creating an effective education strategy plays a critical role. When explaining it to the society, it is important to emphasize the positive results and positive effects that will come by determining the main idea by emphasizing important points. And like any radical change, a new justice system paradigm may face legal, ethical, and social challenges, which must be addressed, and future vision for the future. It is necessary to evaluate the future role and evolution of a common justice system in Islamic countries, just as the European Court of Human Rights. We need to look at evolution of justice. Please wrap up. Compatible with the richness of Islamic law, the common justice system of the future will evolve based on basic principles of Islam, and technology and justice, the change caused by digitalization will also help us implement these systems, and social participation, diversity will also be useful in shaping the justice in the future. And final word. This article is not just an article. It's also a call to lay the foundations of a new justice system inspired by law, aimed at evaluating and improving existing infrastructures and adopting bold reforms internationally. The most ideal mechanism to ensure justice in our age is democracy. The most needed ground for absolute justice is the separation of powers. Thank you very much for your attention. I think I'm a little bit late. No, you're just on time. Thank you very much.